Well, we're doing the final SOCCOM float, and this is Carolyn from Denmark.
Hello.
And she volunteered to do the Krakow dragon because she's awesome at drawing the drawing. Look at that, that's fantastic. But she knows a little bit about the story of the dragon. So are you able to say something about the story? Because you've been there, haven't you?
Yeah, I actually met the Krakow dragon.
Whoa, the real one.
Like, it's a castle on a hill, and then it has like a cave, and in front of the cave they built a statue which spurs fire, spits fire.
Spits fire.
Sometimes you don't really know what it is, and then it says and it's a symbol of the legend of Krakow, that there once were a feisty dragon living underneath the castle and scaring all the citizens of Krakow. And then the king said that he made a contest, so the person who was able to kill the dragon will win his daughter and get married with her. She was called Wanda. And no one was able to fight the dragon, but in the end this poor shoemaker managed to, or was so clever, to fill a sheep with sulfur and give it to the dragon, and the dragon ate the sheep, and then it got so thirsty from the sulfur that it went to the river and then literally drank itself to death.
Oh, they exploded.
Yeah. So it's actually true that you can drink too much water and then die from it. And so he won Wanda.
Excellent.
Yeah.
The artist feels constrained by her body dimensions.
This one was adopted by a school in Poland.
Can you say it in Polish?
It's the Krakow dragon.
The Krakow dragon.
Sweet. That's very good.
All right. Let's go.
Yeah, we'll get the starboard side because it's better for the camera. And it doesn't really matter. Because